This is the Mega Amp. It's a little device that replaces the audio circuitry in the Sega Mega Drive / Genesis systems, and it makes it sound so much better. This one I got is specific to the VA1 Model 2, but you can get it for most Mega Drives and Genesi, even clone systems, and that's pretty damn good. So the first thing we're going to do is take out a bunch of capacitors. That's all them labeled there with the red asterisks. Just take them all out. Now as you zoom in here, there's a little chip resistor, that's what I think they're called, labeled as R21. You take that out as well. Then there are four other chip resistors down here, R22, R24, R73, and R72. You just take them out. Don't forget about that capacitor, you've got to take that one out, that's the mono one. So once you've taken all them out, you can start soldering all your cables to the points. Here's an image I found, you can use this. It tells you where all the cables go and blah 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 blah. I'm a little tired. Okay, I'm almost done, it's got two more cables to go. I've put my circuit on top of the Sega 315 chip, and you can see my soldering skills are not good. I just cover everything with hot glue to hide it away. So I finished, I tested it, it works fine. So let's have the audio comparison. So you might remember back in 2012, I made another audio comparison video similar to this one.
Nobody watches your videos!
Shut up! Well anyway, it went kinda like this.
Alright.
And that's enough of that. But basically, in that video I compared a Mega Drive 2's audio circuitry to a VA1 Model 1's audio circuitry. So I decided, how about I compare the Mega Amp to that same Model 1. So that happened. So here comes my opinion, in which I think the Mega Amp completely destroys the stock Mega Drive 2's audio circuitry. But when compared to the Model 1, the VA1 version of it specifically, the Model 1 comes in a very close second. The changes are subtle, but noticeable. I must also mention that there are two little switches on the circuit that I may have shown you earlier on in the video, which switches the sound from filtered to unfiltered. I keep it on unfiltered because it just keeps it crisper and clearer, but that's just me. With filtered, it just makes it sound a little muddier, and I'm not such a big fan of that. So yeah, that was the Mega Amp for Mega Drive and Genesis systems, and as always, I'll be back in 16 bits.